So I'm sure you've gone to the store before and thought something would be there and it wasn't. And another time you went and there was a ton of it. Why? Something called forecasting and planning. So forecasting, what is it? Forecasting is simply a prediction. It's a guess, an educated guess, based on past experiences. So companies that have been producing these products year after year, they have a ton of data that they can use to determine what their forecast should be of how much, how often, how, when, and how often something should be produced based on a few things. And almost every company that has a product or service use forecasting in some aspect, even if they don't call it forecasting. Your meteorologist or your weather person forecast, right? The weather forecast. They're using past data and instruments to determine what the forecast will be for the week. And that data is pretty accurate at this point in the game. All types of companies use forecasting to determine how much they will sell this year based on how much they sold last year or the year before. Any seasonality that could be associated with a product. This is why you see Valentine's Day items on the shelf in mid to late January. And you see that St. Patrick's Day stuff on the shelf right after Valentine's Day is over with because of forecasting and planning. But forecasting is used in several different aspects. Believe it or not, when you're planning your money to pay bills and things like that, you're forecasting. When you're looking at, is this in the budget? Can I? It's an aspect of forecasting. But let's look at forecasting from a bit of a different perspective because it boils down to knowing the relationship of forecasting and a few other variables that really determines how well a company operates when it comes to their supply chain or just operating efficiently. So first we have what we call customer demand. This is what happens when customer demand goes up, but supply is low, your prices are gonna be high because you have a very hot commodity or product. Everybody wants it, but there's not enough of it. They're going to raise the prices on those things. One, because they can make a profit from it. But two, because it's in such high demand and supply is low, it's going to be very hard to get the product. This happened with the PS5. Now, in most cases, PlayStation didn't raise the prices, but the people that could get the PlayStation, they did raise the prices when it first came out. Now, the opposite happens when supply is high, but demand is low, right? Companies have a ton of inventory and they want to get rid of that inventory as soon as they can, because remember, inventory on the shelf for companies is cash. So we don't want our money just tied up on the shelves. If we can sell it, we're going to mark it down until people actually start buying it because we have too much inventory. So when supply is high and demand is low, that is when you have decreases in prices and price drops and advertisement for things because companies are trying to get rid of inventory. So it starts with customer demand and capacity to meet that demand. How much are the consumers like you and I are asking for of this particular product? Now that we see what they're asking for, let's do some forecasting and apply some forecasting methods to determine, based on consumer demand and the past data that we have, based on consumer consumption, what they've already purchased before, right? Last year, previous year, last 6 months, however you want to run it. Now we can take both of those data points and determine what the forecast should be. Now that we have numbers, legitimate numbers, we can move into our planning phase, right? We're going to produce this much at this time, and we're going to sell it at this price. And then we may increase or decrease that based on past experiences as well as customer demand. The reason customer demand is always important is because sometimes there are trends that are taking place in the marketplace that last year's data will not capture. And because of that, we always have to stay abreast to what's going on in the current industry or the environment so that we can factor that into our forecast. And then the last piece of that is when you begin to schedule things for production, right? Because you can plan, you could forecast based on consumer demand and consumption, but your scheduling is also very important, right? You can't just produce a ton of inventory. It's very expensive to do, and you don't want a lot of it just sitting on the shelves because, one, they have a shelf life, especially perishables or, let's say, bread or milk. You can't produce a lot of that. They have very short expiration dates, right? But even computers and televisions, those products, too, depreciate over time. So companies want to sell their inventory fast. This is where inventory turnover comes in. You want your product on the shelf only so long. So by the time it sells, you want your product right back on the shelf. So you don't want it selling too fast. You don't want it selling too slow. Balance of power, right? But that is forecasting in a nutshell. So key takeaways. Forecasting is just a prediction based on past experiences and customer demand. The important thing is understanding the relationship between customer demand, forecasting, planning, and scheduling.